Hey guys, what's up? I'm Rita, and today I'll show you how to use the camera tracking tool in Adobe After Effects. If you want to be able to make shots like this, or like this, this is one of the first steps you're going to need to know. Alright guys, so before you get to learning any of the cool VFX, like whether it's Super Saiyan or sky replacements, what you're gonna need to know how to do first is how to track the camera movement in your shot. Because say for example, you're on set and you're doing a handheld rig and you move yourself with the camera and now you need to composite something in the background. What this tool does is it tracks the motion of your camera. That way, all of the things that you add to the composition now follow that exact same movement. Just a heads up for those of you still learning, this is something completely different than a tool that we use to track the Android's eyes. That was more of a motion tracking tool, whereas this is actually tracking the motion of your camera that you had on set. All right, let's get to it. Alright guys, if you want, you can download my project file and video clip from the description below. Open up After Effects and import all of your footage and assets. I have my video clip and all the assets I'm going to composite in my bin right here. Alright, so then create a new composition and drop in the video that you want to track. This is a shot that I'll be working with today, and we're going to add a sky as well as a little bit of a dirt explosion. Alright, so the first thing you want to do is duplicate your video layer. Then turn off the bottom layer. Alright, if your shot looks good and there's nothing moving in the foreground, you can right click and hit track camera, but in our shot, Gohan's moving a little bit in the foreground and we don't want that to throw off the track, so we're going to create a mask and cut him out. Select your pen tool up top, then create a mask leaving Gohan out of it. Next, we want to pre-compose this layer, so right click, hit pre-compose, and make sure to select Move All Attributes into the new pre-comp, then hit OK. Now we right-click our new pre-comp and choose Track Camera. You can go up to your Effects tab to see about how long it's going to take. This tool is going to be working in the background, so you can do other stuff while it goes. Once it finishes, scrub through and see how it looks. If everything's perfect, you can go ahead and just click Create Camera, but most likely you're going to need to do some tweaking. There's an advanced drop-down menu where you could choose mostly flat scene, typical, or tripod pan, as well as a detailed analysis. But our auto detect worked pretty good, and most of the time it will. So the point of this tool is to track things in the shot that aren't moving. As you can see, we have some track points on trunks, and we don't want those there because that will throw off the track, so we're going to delete them. You can delete them by selecting them one by one, or selecting and holding down shift, and then hitting delete. And you want to get to a place where the track points are only on the rocks or the sand here in this shot. Alright, once you've deleted all the track points that are on moving people or things, scrub through it and double check everything, and then go up to your Effects tab and click Create Camera. Now you can turn off the layer that has the mask and turn back on your other layer. Alright, next let's add the sky layer. So you want to go to your Project tab and find the sky layer. Then drag it and drop it into the composition below the camera tracker. Next, you'll want to make sure to click the 3D box so it follows the motion of the camera tracker that you just created. Now, I already did my sky replacement work, and I'll show you guys how to do this in another tutorial. But for those of you working in my project file, I've made you a composition with my sky replacement layers. So go to that comp, select the layers in order, copy, and paste them below the camera tracker in our working comp. Alright, now let's check out where our sky is in 3D space. Select the sky layer and go to where it says Active Camera. Do the drop-down menu and choose Top Camera. Now we can adjust where the layer sits in 3D space. Since it's a sky, we want to push it to the back. After you place your layer in 3D space, go back to the Active Camera, and then you can resize it, mask it, feather it, blend it, etc. Alright, cool. Everything looks good. Alright, real quick, you can see what the camera tracker is doing by toggling on and off the 3D box to see that the sky would be out of sync with the camera movement without it. So now let's add some more stuff. Select your layer that has the camera tracker on it and go to the Effects tab to select the tracker. We want to add a dirt explosion charge around Trunks' feet, so click your mouse and drag it around to select some track points where you want the dirt charge. Then right-click and choose Create Solid and Camera. First thing is, you'll delete the new camera that you just created. It'll be the top one. Next, select your solid layer. Then go to your project bin and get the dirt charge layer. Be sure to hold Alt while you drag the layer and drop it directly onto the new solid. Now the dirt will be tracked and placed in the correct 3D space. You can always go to your top camera and see where it is in 3D space and make any adjustments. If you use this method, you don't need to click the 3D box. Again, once your layer is placed in 3D space, go back to the active camera and then you can resize, mask, feather, etc. Now do this exact same process to all the other layers that you want to composite. In my case, it's all the other Super Saiyan layers. And everything looks good. Alright, so you can always go back to your top camera and view where everything is in 3D space and make any adjustments. Alright guys, that's it for today. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments below, or if you have any other requests for tutorials, and happy camera tracking. Thank you all for watching, and hopefully you find this tutorial useful. There are other ways to do camera tracking, but personally this is my favorite way, and also I think universally the easiest way to do it. If you have any questions, make sure to drop them below. And until next time, guys, see you later. Make sure to hit that subscribe button and like, comment, share, all that good stuff. Peace out.